Now, moving on, government says it is keen on improving security for digital payments to ensure many Ghanaians embrace a new way of transactions. This follows the launch of a new digital payment roadmap developed by the Ministry of Finance and United Nations-based firm, Better Than Cash Alliance. Speaking on the project, Director of Financial Sector Division at the Ministry of Finance, Samson Akligo, assured consumer protection is key under the policy. Here's more in this report.
The policy document highlights initiatives that will deepen financial inclusion and accelerate economic growth through digital payment systems. Despite some successes chalked in the use of digital payments over the years, the country has experienced some fraudulent financial activities, especially mobile money fraud. Director of Financial Services at the Ministry of Finance, Samson Akligo, assured that consumers are well protected under the new policy.
It's actually a very strong element of the policy. If you go through that, talks about consumer protection, and that also talks about financial education and awareness, and really all these things are drawn from the lessons that we have learned even from the recent financial sector cleanup. So yes, the key, we are very much committed in educating people and strengthening consumer protection across the various regulators. And in fact, some of the regulators, as I've said, I already feel like far advanced in strengthening consumer protection and also in making sure that the issues that you have raised are addressed. Yeah.
He has also expressed confidence that regulators and other stakeholders will work together to make the policy a success.
Quite frankly, these strategies were developed together with stakeholders. In fact, it is a government policy that was done together with private sector participants. It was done with the likes of the World Bank and Better Than Cash and SIGAP. All the regulators on the financial sector were included, and therefore it is more of maybe a Ghana document. So it's not really like government alone bringing a document. It's just like the ownership is there, so we are all working together to be successful. So the launch of the document is actually even going to give an impetus for the stakeholders to even rally around it so that we speed up some of the things that is already been done. You know.
The new initiative is expected to contribute to the ongoing financial inclusion agenda by the government.